Montreal! Yes! I hope everyone's having a good year. Good. I am. I got a watch. I'm a Canadian comic. Got a new watch. Thank you. I can go 200 meters below the water with this watch. I will know exactly what time it is when my head implodes. It's a very handy product. If you are 200 meters below the water, you know what time it is? Time to swim up as fast as you can. Something's gone terribly wrong. You're in danger. Very worried about this watch because I got it in England and they've lied to us before about underwater products, haven't they? I'm nervous. Whenever I travel overseas, you Canadians know this, we often get mistaken for being American. You want to correct that pretty quickly. Immediately, the food will taste better. And the directions you're given may be correct. Last time I was in England, this fellow could not get it through his head that I was Canadian, not American. So I finally freaked out at him. I said, "Look, Nigel." I don't even know if his name was Nigel. I just call all British people Nigel, male or female. They usually answer. It's weird. I said, "Look, Nigel, I'm Canadian, not American." He actually said, "Canadian, American, what's the difference?" Here's the difference. We don't like being mistaken for being American. That's like when people mistake you as a British person for being a moron. It's a subtle but important difference. I'm not gonna be that Canadian comic that says all Americans are fat and stupid. Hey, not all Americans are stupid, all right? Honestly. There are a lot of very smart American network executives backstage right now that might sign me to something. Those people are geniuses. Genius eye. Americans are, I love when they get the, they're not all fat either. It's just that a lot of the ones that are eat a lot of the ones that aren't. And they just end up massive. Massive and on the news. That's what I like. And still, America is better than Canada at soccer. You know who else is better than Canada at soccer? Everyone in the world, that's who. We are terrible. We're so terrible at soccer. We had the World Cup under 20 cup in Canada. We didn't score one goal. Not a single goal. We are a giant country with very lax immigration policies. And we can't find 11 guys. Really? Seriously? Eleven guys who could kick around a soccer ball more effectively than some countries so small that in order to field a team, every male member of the country has to play on the team. That's embarrassing. We don't understand soccer, and I don't understand why. I've broken it down. It's pretty straightforward. Here's what you do. You run, and you kick it. At halftime, you get oranges. It is not that tough. Run, kick it. Oranges. Here's why I don't think we understand it. Unlike any sport that I've ever played growing up, you are not allowed to catch the ball, right? If the ball even touches your hand and you're Italian, you actually explode. It's the weirdest thing. It's weird. I don't know what the soccer rulemakers have made this rule that when the ball is coming at your face, very fast, because those guys can really kick it. It's basically the speed of a rocket. What you want to do is move your hands out of the way and let the leather missile hit you in the face. And if it wouldn't be too much trouble, could you change the direction of the missile? Could you reroute the rocket with your face? And I think that's the point where most Canadians go, you know what? Why don't you guys play? And we'll watch you and drink.